Hi everyone, Ben from Freemius here. When I was a child, I remember that I really loved going to the supermarket with my parents because I knew that somewhere on one of the aisles there's a stall with a lady that gives away free samples of all kinds of tasty things. The first thing I used to do when entering the supermarket was to look for that lady and hope that today she would be giving away free chocolate. We all love free stuff, and there are a lot of digital products that give their potential customers a free trial of the product to try and convince them to buy the product after the trial expires. One of the most common examples of this is Netflix, of course. It is impossible to even register an account on Netflix without getting a 1 month free trial. Despite the fact that trials are a very common practice in the digital business world, only a fraction of WordPress plugin and theme developers use this pricing approach. In this video, we'll talk about why offering free trials for WordPress products can be very much worth your time and effort. Let's plug in! Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel for future videos. If you're watching this directly on YouTube, you can click the alert icon for notifications about new releases. First of all, not all plugin or theme business owners should offer a free trial without thinking about whether or not it is a sustainable way of making sales. To determine that, you should ask yourself three questions. First, is my product mainly used for a short or long period of time? Second, does my product provide more value for the user over time? And third, does it become harder to switch to a competing product over time? If your product provides more value the longer it's used, takes more time to switch from it, and is usually used for a long period, you should definitely experiment with offering a free trial to lure users to try it out. If, for example, you've created a reviews plugin and your users accumulate many reviews over time, they won't want to risk losing all the reviews if they need to switch to another plugin. They've already invested their time setting up your plugin and using it to store valuable reviews, which makes them pretty committed. Another example is themes. Website owners usually spend a lot of time tweaking and customizing a theme for their specific needs, sometimes even adding custom CSS of their own. After investing all that time and effort setting their site up, it is unlikely that they will change their chosen theme. That's why offering a free trial for most themes is a really good idea. On the other hand, free trials for products that are rarely used, like data export plugins, or products that are used for a short period, like coming soon themes, are bad candidates for free trials. Think about how absurd it is business-wise to offer a 30-day trial for a theme that is usually used for much less time. The bottom line is deciding for each of your plugins or themes if trials are the best way of getting users to commit to buy. After you've decided that you should offer a trial period for your WordPress product, you face a major challenge inherent in the nature of WordPress. This is, of course, the fact that WordPress is open source and anyone can abuse the trial you provide, which means stealing your code and using the premium features of your product without paying. The best way to defend yourself from trial abuse is to start thinking like a SaaS company by adding a licensing engine to your product that is connected to an external service, so that you'll be able to block certain features or even entire access to your product when the trial period ends. You might be wondering if creating a licensing mechanism is compliant with a GPL license, and it most certainly is. If you want to learn more about dealing with code-stealing trolls or how to think like a SaaS company, be sure to watch the videos I created about these topics on our channel. Creating and maintaining a licensing engine by yourself is not an easy task. Plus, it involves addressing trial code logic differently than regular license logic. If, for example, you allow users to keep using paid features after license expiration, you'll have to implement some custom logic to act differently for trials and block access for those cases. When examining the most popular sales platforms used by WordPress plugin and theme shops, Freemius is the only one that offers a complete out-of-the-box trial engine that supports trials with and without a payment method. Envato's marketplaces, Code Canyon and ThemeForest, are not very in touch with sellers, offering only a few integration options and simply don't focus on these kinds of capabilities. EDD offers an extension for offering trials with a payment method, but it's not completely integrated with the software licensing extension, and it requires payment details to be collected upfront when I last checked. WooCommerce does allow trials both with and without a payment method, but controlling how the product will function during the trial period is complex and requires substantial development resources. Freemius's licensing engine offers all kinds of free trial options out of the box with flexible and easy configuration, which allows you to experiment and see what improves conversion rates best for your business. Let's dive deeper into the benefits trials can provide. Even though it's not easy creating a trial engine in a WordPress environment, it has some benefits that are worth the time and effort. Let's go back to conversion rates, this time armed with data, because numbers don't lie. We analyzed data from dozens of plugins and themes sold through Freemius that offer free trials and found that the average conversion rate from a free trial without a payment method to becoming a customer is 18.8%. That's an incredible number. It means that on average, every fifth customer that starts a free trial will become a paying customer. When adding a payment method for a free trial, the conversion rate becomes unbelievable. 69.7%, 7 out of 10 users will end up paying for the product. The moment you convince a user to start a free trial, you are raising the chances that they will end up paying for the product by hundreds or thousands of percent. The hard part is to get users to start the trial in the first place, which is not easy. But with a few tricks I'm going to share, you can increase the likelihood that users will start your free trial. First trick, exit intent pop-ups. Even though they are usually used for offering promotional content or discounts, they do a pretty good job when offering a free trial, just as the user moves his mouse cursor to the top of the page in intention to exit your website. We use the WeBounce JavaScript library on our blog, and we are very happy with it. Second trick, on the checkout page, if the user hasn't provided an email address, you can identify when users navigate to another page on your site and trigger a pop-up that will offer a free trial before abandoning the checkout process. Third trick, including a free trial in a cart abandonment recovery email campaign. Our experience shows that only 1 out of 5 users will finish their purchase. So that's why Freemius automatically sends the other 4 customers a series of 3 emails reminding them to complete their purchase. Offering a free trial as a part of these emails can be a really effective way to convince users to take the leap. Fourth trick. If you are selling a freemium plugin or theme, and the free version is hosted on WordPress.org, the Freemius SDK automatically displays a promotional notice in the WordPress admin dashboard after 24 hours, encouraging the user to switch from the free version of your product to the fully featured free trial, so they can give it a shot. We've discovered that this trick can be very effective at increasing conversion rates. Additionally, one of the main reasons for Netflix financial success, putting their content aside for a moment, is the fact that you have to start a free trial for a month in order to use the platform in the first place. 100% of potential customers will start a free trial, which significantly improves their conversion rates. But because they require credit card details, it lowers the overall number of potential customers that sign up. The lesson to remember is that the best way to use free trials is by testing several variations to find the right balance for your WordPress product. Another benefit of trials is that when you offer something for free, it is okay to ask for something in return. By asking for a user's email address, which is very common, or Twitter handle, you can add them to your marketing funnel. Slowly drip content through email marketing or targeted campaigns on social networks, and increase the chances of converting them into paying customers. If you are considering offering trials for your WordPress plugins or themes, you need to decide on the best type of trial for your WordPress product. There are three popular types of trials used in the ecosystem. First, a free trial without a payment method, where users just need to provide their email address. This type has the least risk for users, since there is a 100% guarantee that they won't be accidentally charged. And you, as the seller, should make it clear on your pricing page that there is no risk to take advantage of the trial, so you can attract more potential customers. Second, a free trial with a payment method. This type has much higher conversion rates, since you'll have fewer, yet more committed users who sign up. Customers are hesitant about free trials with payment details for a few reasons. First, they'll need to remember to actively cancel their subscription if they want to avoid a charge. Plus, they need to trust you not to scam them or charge them unexpectedly. The big advantage of this trial type is that users that go through the free trials funnel are considered to be more serious and they have already taken the hardest step, providing their credit card details. I mentioned earlier that this method has the highest conversion rates. A whopping 7 out of 10 users will probably continue their subscription after the trial expires. The third type of trial is a paid trial with a discount. In the WordPress ecosystem, this is sometimes offered as a coupon on the first payment for special occasions, like in Black Friday, for example. Unlike the previous two trial types I mentioned, where you won't get any money unless the trial converts, leveraging a discounted trial approach will contribute some revenue to your balance sheet every time someone starts a trial. That's all for our first part. Stay tuned for part 2, where we'll talk about the best free trial length, learn how to prevent abuse of your code, and share other strategies to maximize your free trial pricing efforts. In the meantime, you're welcome to subscribe to our YouTube channel to receive a notification when part 2 is released. See you then! They won't want to risk losing all the reviews if you... The moment you convince a user to start a free trial, you are raising the chances that they... If you are selling a freemium plugin or theme, and the free version is hosted on...